Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you some tips for using column view in the Finder on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So of the three primary views in the Finder, column view is my favorite and the one I use the most. So here's a typical Finder window with column view. I'm in my home folder here and I've selected documents and then I have the list of all the folders in my documents folder. Now one of the disadvantages to column view is that you've got limited space to see file names. For instance, if you look here, the third to the last item here, you can't see the whole file name. You see three dots in the middle and the beginning and the end of the file name. But you can always move your cursor over it and wait, and then you'll see the full file name pop up. Now if you want to expand or shrink the columns, all you need to do is move your cursor over the line between columns and then you'll see the cursor change. Then click and drag to the right or left to change the column width. So let's add some more columns here. I'm going to click on this folder here and it will reveal more content inside that folder, and then I'll click on a folder in there as well. Now if I want to change the column size for all of the columns at once, all I need to do is move my cursor over the line between any two columns, then hold the Option key down and drag to the right or left, and it will change all of the column widths at once. Now usually when you're resizing the width of a column, the idea is to either show longer file names in there or to shrink it to save space, like over here. You can quickly do that by double clicking on any line. So I'm going to move my cursor over this line here, and if I just double click, you can see it will shrink to a minimum size. In this case, there is a file name that's longer here. So if I double click here, it actually expands, so it's the perfect size for the longest file name. Now you can combine these by holding the Option key down and double clicking on any line. And that will set every column to the exact right size. Some columns to the minimum size, some columns to the exact size for the longest file name in that column. Now if you control click on the line between columns, you have some options. You could right size that column, you can right size all columns individually, or you could right size all columns equally. That will set them all to the same size that's needed for the longest file name in any column. Now one of the things I love about column view is that you can navigate completely with the keyboard. So here I have the documents folder selected. If I were to use the down arrow, it would go to the folders below it. Up arrow goes up. The right arrow will go down into the folder that's selected. And then I can use the right arrow to go down further. Then I can navigate all the way down here. I can use the left arrow to go back. I can navigate all around in the different columns just using the four arrow keys. Now you can also use letter keys too, which of course works best as long as everything's sorted alphabetically. So for instance, if I were to hit the P key, it jumps right to the first entry in the selected column using that. But if I wanted to jump further, like say to the pics folder there, if I just do PI, it will jump to that. Now you can use keyboard navigation to easily move files around using copy and paste. So we know that copy is command C and paste is command V, but if you hold the Option key down, paste will change to move. So Option command V moves a file. So for instance, let's use the arrow keys to go up into the docs folder here, go to the right, go down here to images, go to the right, and let's say we want to move this file. I can now do command C to copy it. It doesn't do anything right away, but now I'm going to left arrow back here. Let's go into this folder here, and I could use command V to paste a copy here or Option command V to move the file. So I can move a file around just using the keyboard. You can also use undo, command Z, to undo any move like that. Now you can also do this with the cursor using drag and drop. So let's go into images here, and I could take this file and I could drag it over to here, and let's go into project A, wait a second, and it's spring loaded. It will then show the content in this column here. I can go to this folder here and then I can drop it in there. So I can easily move a file around almost anywhere on my hard drive in one window with the Finder in column view. Now you may have noticed that when I have a file selected, like say this one, I see a preview here on the right. And that's true of almost any file type. Here's a PDF, here is an image. All of these files will show me different previews to the right here. If you don't see the preview, go to View and you should see Show Preview here rather than Hide Preview. If you would rather not see these previews, you can hide them and then the space to the right in column view will just be blank. With this preview shown, it will use all the remaining space for the preview and it will give you lots of information based on the file type. So here for an image, for instance, I could see some general information about it, but I could also click Show More and see lots of detailed image specific information. And you also get some quick action buttons down here at the bottom of the preview area. Also notice here I've got the full path at the bottom. If you don't see that, you can turn that on by going to View and then Show Path Bar. And also there's Show and Hide Status Bar as well, which is what shows me the information like the number of files at the bottom there and the available space on my drive. Now there are some preferences that you can set as well. What you need to do is go to View and then Show View Options. But most people use Command J as the keyboard shortcut. This brings up this little control here. So we have some options. One is to change the text size. Default is 12, but let's say I go up to 16 here. You can see I get much larger text here and the icons enlarge to fit as well. I can also go smaller if I want. Now notice there are icons to the left here, folder icons in most cases and some file icons there too. If I want to get rid of those and just see the names, I can turn that off. If I do have icons on, I can decide whether or not I see little icon previews, little pictures here for images and such. So I can turn that off. This is helpful if you're using an older Mac and you're going through lots of files. It takes less processing power if it doesn't have to generate all those previews. And sometimes people just don't like to see them. It creates a little more visual clutter. Now notice here you also have group by and sort by. We can also go and do those here. So I can say let's sort by kind instead. And this will change it for all columns. So if I go into this miscellaneous folder here, things are going to be sorted by kind. Notice all the PDFs are together, for instance. So you have various sort by options. Probably date last opened or date added or modified or created are some of the most useful. Size isn't that useful in column view because you can't really see the sizes. But you could also, instead of doing sort by, we can do use groups. And now sort by is group by instead. So now we can group things, in this case, by kind. But we could also group them in other ways, like say by date last opened. And I'll group them together here. You can see years and months. Now let's turn that off and let's say we want everything to be alphabetical but we'd rather have the folders at the top. Well, that's actually a Finder preference. So if we go to Finder Preferences here, we can go to Advanced and say that we want to keep folders on top in Windows when sorting by name. So let me select that. And now we see the folders are at the top and alphabetical and then all the files. I think this is particularly useful in column view where when you're digging down into subfolders you have all the folders here at the top and then all the files following them below. But do note that if you change the sort by option to something else like date last opened then you get folders mixed in. And the same thing when you use groups and say you were to group by date last opened you can see the folders mix in with the files. So one last thing I want to show you is you could actually use a lot of these tricks inside of the open and save dialogs in apps. By default, most of these go to column view here, but you have a control to switch between icon view, list view, and column view. So when I'm in here, I can click and drag the lines between columns. I could double click on a column. I can right click and get all the different options. I can do all those things to control column width. I can also use keyboard navigation to get around inside of these. You can see I could also go in here and group items as well. And when I move my cursor over a longer name there, you can see it shows me the full name there. So it pays to learn these column view tricks even if you don't use column view all the time in the Finder because you're going to see it a lot here when you're navigating to open and save files. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.